Look at the river as it winds down the rise like a tear going down.
Hi guys, so I'm here doing the hospital bag and what I have in my hospital bag. I do always want to remind everyone I'm a first time mom, so this doesn't mean these things are totally necessary, but being a Girl Scout, being prepared, so hopefully I'm in the right spot. If there's any suggestions that you're seeing that are not in my bag and you have been to the hospital giving birth, feel free to just leave them down below, or if you have any questions about what I put in here, let me know, comment below. So first off, I am just using a duffel bag that I already have. I know some people go out of their way and buy a new special bag, which I don't think is necessary. If you already have something, just use it. You don't need to buy everything new. So anyways, this shouldn't be a long-term thing, and you're not going on like some fancy trip or anything like that. You're going to the hospital. So the first thing, this is in my outside pouch. I have glasses. They're not in here yet because obviously I use my glasses. And contact solution, and then I'll be throwing in a contacts container. So those are just easy reach on the outside of the bag because I could be going in with my contacts on and I want to switch them out or something like that. Next, I picked up kind of this neutral binder. So this has zebras on it. I got it at Target. I thought it was really cute, just the animals. I thought it would be fun for the baby and gender neutral. So I brought this. I want to bring this just to keep baby's things organized. So if we get anything in the hospital, paperwork, that sort of thing, this is going to be baby's binders. I'm all about binders. I'm not really into filing cabinets here. We work out of binders, so we have binders for just whatever you need. So like auto and insurance and healthcare. So this will become baby's binder. And then next, I got a couple of things. This will be makeup. I do need to throw in a couple of things of makeup. Probably just, you know, like mascara and just some like under eye coverage. I'm not going all out, guys. I've kind of put everything in Ziplocs, so like the gallon size Ziplocs organized with Sharpie what they have on them. I think I could use probably any of those toiletry bags like this. However, that doesn't mean my husband's going to know what's inside them. So I put them in Ziplocs so I can just say, can you get me such and such? And he can go ahead and grab whatever I need, and we can just see what's inside of them. So the couple things I'm not showing you are baby's going home outfits because we are keeping the gender a secret. So those types of things I am not going to pull out of the bag, but they are in here. I threw in some socks, I think just like a swaddle blanket, and then two pairs of pajamas, and then the legit outfit that Ben and I went ahead and picked out, and we ended up getting that at Old Navy on sale. Well, it wasn't on sale, but they were having a sale. Couple of toiletry items. I picked this up in the toiletry section, or the travel toiletry section at Target. So I thought it was really cute because it comes with the toothbrush holder, little bag, and a toothpaste all ready to go. I use an electric toothbrush and I don't usually like to lug my electric toothbrush everywhere, so I will be set to go there. I did grab a Poof. I've been really into this throughout pregnancy. It feels really good massaging wise, so I threw this in, so we will have that for cleaning and just, I don't know, feeling good. I did throw in a bathrobe. This is from Target. It's kind of old, but it still works. I was tempted to buy a new one, but I really don't need one. So it's just a simple black shorter nightgown, something cozy, and just to feel good. So even if I'm wearing a gown, I can put this over the gown and just feel a little bit more homey. I am throwing in slippers. These are just kind of cheap slippers from Target. They're like, I think they might be the Jillian O'Malley, I can't remember. So just slippers that I don't care as much about. I have Minnetonka's, but I don't really want to bring those. So obviously a hairbrush. This is a Paul Mitchell hairbrush. This is just another Vera Bradley pouch, and in this one I just have elastics and bobby pins, those sorts of things, so hair essentials. Next, this is socks and underwear. So again, I'm putting everything in those gallon Ziplocs. So I just got some, like, nothing fancy granny panties. And just a bunch of pairs of socks. I did put these in. These are from my grandmother, and I thought they were really nice of her. So these are from, they're called Mucklocks. I'm not really sure where she bought them. Basically, they're those spa kind of fuzzy socks, and they do have the grips on the bottom. They're kind of cute because they have a Mary Jane design. So I thought those were kind of cute for slippers and just staying cozy. It is going, you know, if all goes well, it'll be December, late November. So these are going to be amazing. Any kind of fuzzy socks, I think, are a good thing to have in your hospital bag. Last minute grabs are going to be like chargers and headphones and that sort of thing. I found these in the scarf bag accessory section at Target. And they're just mesh kind of see-through bags, and they do hook together. And I thought these were just super awesome for your electronics. So I can actually put like a camera in here, and I can put, what else? Like just charge cords and those sorts of things. Those are going to be last minute grabs, obviously. So, and I will have just a small list on top of the bag of things we need to grab that aren't in the bag. Oh yeah, I already pulled that out. I am bringing this along, and it's the, just the cover, nursing cover. So hopefully, I shouldn't need it, but say I do, I don't know. I am bringing that along. I did bring some foot cream, foot and leg foot cream. It's from Burt's Bees. It's peppermint oil and rosemary leaf extract. So I think that'll be super good. So in baby's bag, I also, so we ordered a trial size box of Honest diapers. And so they sent us a travel size wipes. So I thought that would be perfect for baby's bag. And then my grandmother did say that the hospital should have this kind of thing, but just in case we need them for the ride home or we do need our own, you never know. I did pack about 3 diapers. These are from the Honest brand. I'm not sure if I'm really committing to the Honest brand. They're really cute though. Look at like little balloons and elephants. I'm not sure that I'm really committing to them. They are kind of expensive, but these ended up being about the same price as maybe Pampers when I was shopping. So I ended up just getting them and just we'll try them out. So they're the newborn size. So I think they fit up to like, I don't know, like 12 pounds. So I hope I don't have a 12 pound baby. I'm just kidding. So anyways, so these are also thrown in. And so hopefully baby's bum really likes those. So those are in the baby's bag. So toiletry wise for me, a couple things. Dry shampoo. I might not give a damn about washing my hair, so I do love the dry shampoo. I do skip anyways, so with pregnancy, I think my hair's just kind of dried out. Just been super hard to manage and like very straw feeling. So sometimes I do skip a day just to try to keep that moisture in there. So dry shampoo is awesome. I did put a razor in here in case I want it. I don't know. Just kind of like when you pack for a trip. So I just got a couple Tresemme shampoo and conditioners. And then just little makeup towelettes, so remover towelettes. These are just from the Target No Name brand, Up and Up. I did grab, I haven't used these in forever. So these are pads, these are the giant overnight pads. If you know, yeah, if you've been there, you know what's going on. So these are probably necessary, and so I threw like 5 in these, and then I also made like a postpartum basket for the bathroom, and the rest of the package of those overnight pads are in there in case I need them. I brought some clothes for myself. So for me, I just brought like a super comfortable loose fitting shirt, yoga pants, so with the wide band at the top, so something super comfortable. I'm just thinking if there's some reason I need an emergency C-section. I have something comfortable as far as waistband goes. And then these are just kind of pajamas, sweatpants, super simple. Throw in, oh, that's just another headband. So I picked up this. No nursing bras have been able to fit me correctly. Hoping I can find something maybe post-pregnancy, not sure yet. In the meantime, I found this. It's just a nursing cami from the Jillian O'Malley company from Target. So it was about $20, and it has the easy-use clips, so you can pull those down when you need them. So I will be using that. It's super comfortable. I got it in this oatmeal color, which I thought was really cute. And I could even throw that underneath a t-shirt. And then I did pick up, these are just the wide band shorts, in case I need those. And then I picked up just a pair of comfortable, kind of luxurious feeling from Target, pajama pants, something special, just for me kind of thing. So I'm not wearing just all clothes that are just kind of old and things in my drawer. To go along with the pads, these are, this is kind of with research with Pinterest and YouTube. is hemorrhoid relief, cooling hemorrhoid pads. I have some kind of idea about how these will, why I need those, but I've seen that people have suggested them. So I just picked up the Up and Up no name brand just to have them. You never know. The last few things that I got, I did put in a massager. This is some Brookstone. So you just kind of press it like this. It's battery operated. We just have this around in case we need it. And in our birthing class, they did suggest things like this for during labor. So I put this in here just in case. I don't have them in here, but they're in the bathroom. Just swim trunks for Ben and a bathing suit for me in case I need it. And those are for the soaking tub. They do recommend at our hospital to have your partner have their own swimsuits. And you, I don't know if I'm supposed to, maybe, I don't know. Anyways, they have, I think it is just for him, probably to keep things clean. So for me, I can just go naked, I guess. So anyways, they do have the soaking tub available in the birthing center when we toured this past weekend. So I did throw in the swimsuits in case we want them. And I will have to throw in some things for Ben, just like maybe a pair of sweatpants and a t-shirt. Some underwear and socks if he wants, and slippers. I did throw in for me a couple snacks like chocolate chip granola bars, just a little bit of a pick-me-up if I want them. And then I threw in gum. I love gum. I don't know how this gum has survived being in the house, probably because it's been zipped away, because I go through gum like no tomorrow. And then I did throw in just a little tiny tin of Altoids, just the wintergreen smalls. I've heard that it can be really annoying if other people's breath stinks, so these might be for me, but they might be also for people in the room. And then for Ben, I grabbed him just some beef jerky so he can feel super manly. I might even eat this myself, too. I just thought this would be kind of a fun snack to have in the bag for him. So hopefully that's true and he ends up liking that option. Other than that, I think that's all I have in my bag. I think my last minute grabs are going to be probably the camera, obviously, my phone, wallet, insurance cards, that sort of thing. My insurance card's already in my wallet, so I guess I don't need that.
So I have my own Kleenex, just because some of the Kleenex at the hospital can be kind of harsh. I also packed this. One of my best friends just sent me this. It's this adorable little pouch. And I put inside just like essential oils that I might like lemon. The big one is, oh, I really like this. It's a Thieves oil from Young Living. And then I just put like a normal lavender, which I think will also be super useful if I want to use these.
I might throw in another t-shirt that I have. Other than that, I think that's all we have. The car seat is already in the car, so we don't need to grab that. So we'll be good there. The other thing the hospital did suggest, if you want to bring some DVDs, and I could bring my like friends' DVDs. So I may end up throwing those in, but we will see. So that is in my hospital bag. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this. Again, it's just a duffel, and hopefully I have what I need. I think the other thing's going to be a jacket, but I'll probably wear that out of the house. So I don't think I need the jacket in here. Maybe a sweatshirt if I think of it. Oh, that's what I forgot. So I am going to throw in some flip-flops for, like, if I want them for the shower or just wandering around if I don't want to wear slippers. Thank you guys for watching, and stay tuned for more videos. Bye.
Holding the life of our own, though we do.